Everyone, it's Ivan with KeepAdger.com out here today to tell you about the most recent insidious move by the ATF with respect to pistol braces and how you can hopefully help. I know, right? 2020 is not over yet. So backstory is probably important. SB Tactical, what became SB Tactical a number of years back, went to the ATF, said, hey, we want to make a pistol brace. This is what we're doing. We want approval. They said, okay, cool. We approve it. Fast forward a little bit, ATF says, we're gonna change our mind. SB Tactical is like, no, you're not. And they go to bat on behalf of the entire gun industry, battle them out in courts, they win. So we have pistol braces. Fast forward a number of years. ATF has continually kind of just really gone after different companies in shady ways. Like, they're literally the regulatory arm, and they're supposed to make regulations. And SB Tactical has been like, why don't you just outline the criteria for a pistol brace so we don't have to continually resubmit to get your blessing on these different braces? And they're like, nah, we don't really want to. And at the same time, constantly trying to dig at SB Tactical and other companies. Till finally, phone call comes down to ATF's daddy, DOJ, and they're like, hey, knock it off. Stop moving the goalpost, going after these companies that are making braces, like, by not giving them good guidance on this stuff, or not giving them any guidance for that matter. So ATF goes and sulks and says, okay, well, we're not gonna go after SB Tactical anymore. We'll just go after companies that are using braces made by SB Tactical, hence Q, and their cease desist. Again, principal calls their dad and is like, hey, your idiot son, still causing trouble. DOJ is like, all right, my bad. 60-day cease and desist on your cease and desist, Q. Meanwhile, hey, you know what we should probably do? We should probably come up with a criteria, since we're the regulatory arm, for braces. That would kind of make sense. So, hey, ATF, my stupid child, why don't you go do this? So the ATF does that. They basically roll their face back and forth across the keyboard and come up with 15 pages. So what's the gist of this 15-page document that the ATF put out? Keep in mind, someone, at least one person at the ATF, has a conscience and actually leaked it to the industry like 2 days before it's gonna get posted. Why is this important? Well, we'll get to that later, but basically it's time sensitive. So again, what is in the document? The document's ridiculous. It literally reads like a terms of service agreement from like Facebook or YouTube, which says, hey, we don't really want to actually outline what the criteria is for anything, i.e. we're not gonna tell you what calibers can have a pistol brace, we're not gonna tell you barrel length of pull, or anything like that. But these are criteria we're gonna look at, and unlike just say banning your account or something like that, we're gonna come shoot your dog, take you away to prison if you violate these terms, which we're not really gonna outline for you. Literally a regulatory agency that's supposed to create regulation on this, and their solution is, hey, we're gonna make it so vague that at a whim, we can decide what is or is not a pistol brace. Not only that, but we're talking about something that will literally land you in federal prison, $10,000 fine, and people with guns are gonna come take you away if you violate this. That's what the ATF did. Which brings us to those 2 weeks and being insidious. So from the date of them posting that paper, there's basically 2 weeks for comments and concerns with respect to that submittal. So now's the time to activate. And of course, it came at the end of arguably probably one of the more stressful years for most people, when people are slowly trying to just kind of wind down, spend time with families, and yeah, drop this in everyone's lap. So what can be done? Down below, there's a link. It'll take you over where you can basically let them know how you feel about this. Maybe encourage them to, in a very black and white way, possibly do their job and actually define all those different criteria that make a pistol brace. And I know there's some people out there that are like, oh, well, what about in there it says if my pistol is now going to be reclassified as a short-barreled rifle, then maybe they're going to waive the $200 tax stamp and expedite the paperwork. Oh, it's a win. Like, I don't have to. No, that's not a win. It is a huge backdoor scam to gun registration. And in addition to that, when you register things with the NFA, National Firearms Act, you literally open the door for them to come into your house and inspect said weapons. Again, gun registration, opening the door for gun confiscation. It is a scam. I would encourage everyone to go follow those links and actually give your feedback. Hopefully this whole thing will get nipped in the bud. And you're like, does this process even work? In the past, it has. A while back, again, ATF and their infinite wisdom were like, we're gonna go ahead and ban M855 ammunition. There was enough of an outcry from the public in the entire industry. And they said, oh, maybe we're being stupid, because they were, and they backed off that. Hopefully this will result in the same thing, or at the very least, maybe them just doing their job and actually outlining for the industry what constitutes a pistol brace so everyone can move on with their lives and not become felons overnight with a crime, with ironically without a victim, which ipso facto does not make a crime, like possession of something that magically, like, oh, you're a criminal. It's not a thing, but they'll still come shoot your dog and take you to prison. So we want to basically head this off at the pass. Again, I encourage you to go down, follow those links, and yeah, make your voice heard. This is much bigger than just a brace thing. Just like, honestly, the whole bump stock thing is much bigger than bump stocks. It's about individual freedoms and liberty, which this entire nation was founded on. And Second Amendment protects every other amendment. So might want to get behind this. But as always, thanks for joining us at kitbadger.com. Look forward to seeing you next time. Oh, one more thing before we go. This involves everyone. Need everyone to get behind this. Talking to you, Grandmaster Jay. Would definitely appreciate you getting behind this. Maybe holding a peaceful protest with the NFAC over at 244 Needy Road in Martinsburg, West Virginia. Appreciate the help. Fingers straighten off the trigger.